أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فإذا قرأت القرآن فاستعذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إنه ليس له سلطان على الذين آمنوا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم. Quran Weekly. We are now on the 14th juz and I'm reading to you from Surah An-Nahl, the 16th surah. And this is the 98th ayah of the surah, in which Allah says, فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ. Then whenever you recite the Quran, look at فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ, not فَإِن قَرَأْتَ, not if you recite the Quran, when you recite the Quran. Allah expects you to recite the Quran, because if the expectation was not there, it would have been an if you recite it, when you recite it. Allah says, when you recite it, then فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ, then seek Allah's refuge, مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ, from the cursed shaitan. When you recite the Quran, shaitan will come and try to put you to sleep. When you recite the Quran, shaitan will put evil thoughts in your head. When you recite the Quran, you will remember the other 20 things you had to do and finish it off quickly. This is going to happen when you're praying. This is going to happen when you're just sitting there reciting Quran, when you're trying to memorize, when you're just in the plane and you got time and you just pull out the Mus'haf and start reading. It is going to happen every single time. And so every single time, seek Allah's refuge from the cursed shaitan. Say, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ, before you start reciting the Qur'an, a commandment of Allah Azza wa Jal, because this is a really important part of your relationship with the Qur'an. And the one thing shaitan wants is a distance between you and Allah. Qur'an will bring you close to Allah. He hates that, so he wants to corrupt your experience with the Qur'an. Everything he can do to corrupt that experience. إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ لَهُ سُلْطَانَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. No doubt about it, he has no authority over those who truly have iman, who truly have faith. وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and those who place their trust in Allah. In other words, Allah didn't overwhelm us with fear of, oh shaitan, the devil's here, he's gonna mess me up. Actually, if you trust Allah and say, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ, you believe Allah is enough to guard you. Allah is enough to protect you. So when you recite Qur'an, make sure that you seek Allah's refuge. Also, this isti'adha is not just because He will distract you or not let you, you know, finish your recitation or make you lazy. It's also because He'll make you misunderstand, misinterpret. He'll make you want to think something is there that isn't there. So you're saying Allah's refuge shouldn't just be a recitation like أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. You should genuinely seek Allah's, Ya Allah, protect me. I'm about to go enter into your book. I'm about to engage your book. I genuinely need your protection from the cursed shaitan who can take guidance and turn it into misguidance for me if I'm not careful. May Allah protect all of us and our recitation of the noble Qur'an, and may Allah keep shaitan away from our recitation of the Qur'an.